Dear students, today I am going to talk on lac insect. Lac is one of the most valuable gifts of nature to man. It is also unique material in as much as it is the only resin of animal origin, being actually the secretion of a tiny insect, Lacifera lacca. It is remarkable that even thousands of years back, people used to collect or regularly grow and put it to diverse uses. It is, however, difficult to conjecture exactly when and how it was first exploited for utility purposes. It is not unlikely, however, that the color, which is so striking and attractive, should have first drawn attention. Further, the fact that the dye can be straight away used without having to be processed in any way also suggests that the dye might have been the first to be exploited. Possibly, the medicinal value was also simultaneously known. The recognition of the usefulness of the resin might have come later. Since ancient times, Greeks and Romans were familiar with the use of lac. The cultivation of lac insects has a long history in Asia, with some suggestion that it is as old as 4,000 years in China, where its cultivation accompanied the development of the silk industry. Lac is nature's gift to mankind and the only known commercial resin of animal origin. It is the hardened resin secreted by tiny lac insects belonging to a bug family. To produce 1 kg of lac resin, around 3 lac insects loses their life. The lac insects yields resin, lac dye and lac wax. Application of these products has been changing with time, lac resin, dye, etc. Still find extensive use in Ayurveda and Siddha systems of medicine. The importance of lac in the modern economy, particularly of India and Thailand, is quite considerable. It earns for Indian foreign exchange to the tune of 90 crore of rupees per annum. India interest in lac stems from other considerations also. It provides spare time occupation to some 5 million cultivars, mostly aboriginals, who form the poorest section of the country's population. Its cultivation also does not require any capital, which makes it all the more welcome to the poor roids. Lac also provides employment to some 30,000 persons, either as workers in the small scale factories or as intermediaries in the export trade, and altogether accounts for a good deal of economic activities of the country. The exports of lac from India reached a quantitative peak in 1956-57, totaling 42,840 tons, valued at ₹23.4 million. Coming to the lac distribution, the commonest and the most widely occurring species of lac insect in India is Lacifera lacca, which produces the bulk of commercial lac. 14 species of the genus have been recorded in India, but much confusion prevails regarding their exact identity, and it is possible that many of them are only strains or varieties of Lacifera lacca. Some of these species found in India occur also in other countries. Lacifera albizia, for instance, is found in Ceylon. Lacifera chinese is the chief source of commercial lac in Thailand. other countries in which Lacifera species occurrence include Burma, Cambodia, Laos, North Vietnam, China, Formosa, Indonesia, Philippines, Malaya, Pakistan, Nepal, Sikkim and Bhutan. India and Thailand are main areas in the world, while India has prime position in relation to the lac production. Lac cultivation is introduced into Thailand from India. Over 90% of Indian lac produced comes from the states of Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Northern Orissa. Lac insect is a minute crawling scale insect which inserts its sectorial proboscis into plant tissue, sucks juice, grows and secretes resinous lac from the body. Its own body ultimately gets covered with lac in the so-called cell. Lac is secreted by insects for protection from predators. Male is red in color and measures 1.2 to 1.5 millimeter in length. It has reduced eyes and antennae. Thorax bears a pair of hyaline wings. Female is larger than male, measures 4 to 5 millimeter in length. Thorax, abdomen are not clearly distinct. The antennae and legs are in degenerated form and wings are absent. The life cycle of lac insect takes about 6 months and consists of stages, egg, nymph, instars, pupae and adult. The lac insects have an oviparous mode of reproduction. Female lays 200 to 500 ready to hatch eggs. That is, the embryos are already fully developed in eggs when these are laid. Eggs hatch within a few hours of laying and a crimson red first instar nymph called crawlers come out. The crawlers measures 0.6 into 0.25 millimeter in size. The emergence of nymph is called swarming and it may continue for 5 weeks. The nymphs crawl about on branches on searching soft succulent twigs. The nymphs settle down close together at rate of 200 to 300 insects per square inch. At this stage, both male and female nymphs live on the sap of the trees. They insert their sectorial proboscis into plant tissue and suck the sap. After a day or so of settling, the nymphs start secreting resin from the glands distributed under the cuticle throughout the body except mouth parts, breathing spiracles and anus. The resin secreted is semi-solid, which hardens on exposure to air into a protective covering. The nymphs molt thrice inside the cells before reaching maturity. The duration of each instar is dependent on several factors wise: temperature, humidity and host plant. After the first molt, both male and female nymphs lose their appendages, eye and become degenerate. While still inside their cells, the nymphs cast off their second and third molt and mature into adult. Both the male and female larvae become sexually mature in about 8 weeks. Only the male one undergoes a complete metamorphosis or transformation into another form. It loses its proboscis and develops antennae, legs and a single pair of wings. It is contained in a brood cell, somewhat slipper-like with a round trap door, operculum, through which it emerges. The adult male is winged and walks over the females to fertilize them. The female brood cell is larger and globular in shape and remains fixed to the twig. The female retains her mouth parts but fails to develop any wings, eyes or appendages. While developing, it really becomes an immobile organism with little resemblance to an insect. Females become little more than egg-producing organisms. The female increases in size to accommodate her growing number of eggs. Lac resin is secreted at a faster rate and a continuous layer, coal sacs, grows into one body. After 14 weeks, the female shrinks in size, allowing light to pass into the cell and the space for the eggs. About this time, two yellow spots appear at the rear end of the cell. The spots enlarge and become orange colored. When this happens, the female has oviposit, a large number of eggs in the space called ovisac. The ovisac appears orange due to crimson fluid called lac dye, which resembles cochineal. It indicates that the eggs will hatch in a week time. When the eggs hatch, larvae emerge and the whole process being all over again. After the cycle has been completed and around the time when the next generation begin to emerge, the resin encrusted branches are harvested. They are scraped off, dried and processed for various lac products. A portion of brood lac is retained from the previous crop for the purpose of inoculation to new trees. Lac insects thrive on twigs of certain plant species, suck the plant sap and grow all the while secreting lac resin from their bodies. These plants are called host plants. Although lac insect is natural pest on host plant, these insects enjoy the privileged position not being treated as pest. This is because they yield a useful product. The host plants are economically not so important and the insect cause only temporary and recoverable damage to the host plants. About 113 varieties of host plants are mentioned as lac host plant, out of which the following are very common in India: jujuba species, Acacia catechu, Acacia arabica, Jujubus xyloporus, Shoria tulura, Cajanus cajan, Ficus bengalensis and Ficus religiosa. It is also important to mention that the quality of lac is directly related to the host plant and to the strain of lac insect. Based on industrial parameters, Kusumi lac is better and fetches higher price in market. In this respect, beer tree as a potential Kusumi lac host is already getting momentum. This host species is available in plenty and can supplement and fulfill the Kusumi brood lac requirement in many areas. Similarly, Ceres albizia species has also been identified as good host for Kusumi brood lac. The trees can be raised and utilized within a period of 5 to 6 years of plantation in comparison to around 15 years for Kusum. Flamingia simulata is a bushy host plant and has also been identified as well as established as a good Kusumi lac host on plantation basis. Thus, these trees host wise bear Ceres simulata and laterally Prospice Julifolia in Gujarat areas are expected to enhance Kusumi lac cultivation. Adoption of this activity may enhance lac production to the tune of 3 to 4%. Lac cultivation is initiated from brood lac, which is the twig of host tree carrying lac encrustation, with larvae about to emerge from mother cells. The twigs are cut, bundled and tied at convenient places on a fresh host plant so that the emerging larvae swarm and settle on nearby succulent shoots. Traditional methods of lac cultivation, however, have not proved always reliable in providing sustained supplies of healthy brood lac for raising 2 crops a year. Optimum yield of lac from a given quantity of brood lac is also not always obtained, and fluctuations in lac production have been the rule in the past. The proper management of the host stock, use of pest-free brood, time and manner of inoculating host plants, and control of pests and predators of the lac insect are all important for ensuring good yields of lac. In recent years, much information of value to lac culture has emerged as result of researchers at the Indian Lac Research Institute at Nukum, Bihar. Improved techniques of cultivation have been evolved. The efforts are being made to popularize them among lac growers. Successful lac cultivation depends on the continuous availability of brood lac in the required quantities. Since different host plants react differently to weather conditions, the brood lac survives better on some host species than on others. This is especially true in the case of hosts during host summers. In order, therefore, to ensure a steady supply of brood lac, it is advisable to have a large variety of trees under lac wherever possible, rather than restrict cultivation to one host. A storage of brood lac periodically occurs in areas where only one host, bir or pals, is exploited for lac production. These two hosts between themselves account for 80% of the annual lac production in India, and being deciduous, they remain leafless for a long period during summer, thus exposing the lac insect to heat, drought and hot winds. In order to overcome this difficulty, in areas where only pals or bir is available, resort may be had to partial pruning of bir and partial defoliation of pals in October-November, just before inoculating the plants. As a result, the trees put forth new leaves which last during hot months and provide shade to the maturing bashiki broods. The second way of preserving adequate brood during the host summer months is to select only hosts which normally have green leaves during summer for raising the bashiki crop. Certain ficus species, notably Ficus cunea and Ficus lacora, and a few leguminous plants like Albizia indica or Virginia vogensensis have proved valuable for this purpose. The insects are serious and damaging pests to the lac crop also. Like the other agricultural crops, These insect pests destroy 30 to 40% of lac. The insects damage the lac crop is two ways as parasites. Lac insects are parasitized by small winged eight species of insects belonging to family Chelicidae, order Hymenoptera. These insect pests lay eggs in lac cells. Their grubs on hatching feed on lac insects within the cells. Loss due to these parasites is 5 to 10%. As predators, the predators account major damage up to 35% of lac crop. There are three main insect predators of lac: Ibilema umbellalensis, Murri, commonly known as white lac moth, Harder Lepidoptera, Olocera pulveria, Meyer, commonly known as black lac moth, Harder Lepidoptera, Chrysopa species, commonly known as lace wing fly, Harder Diptera. These predator moths and fly lay their eggs on the lac encrusted twigs. On hatching, their larvae make their way inside the lac encrustation and feed on the lac insects as well as on lac encrustations. The white lac moth is more destructive on trees, while black lac moth on the stored lac. Composition and use of lac. Lac has many and varied uses. The characteristics that make lac suitable for each diverse applications are thermoplasticity, solubility in alcohol and alkalis, excellent film forming capacity, resistance to hydrocarbons and other solvents, good adhesion to different surfaces, resilience and good electrical properties. Example: high dielectric strength, low dielectric constant, freedom from tracking or arcing under silent electric discharge or breakdown, etc. Besides, it is also non-poisonous and odorless. The major constituents of stick lac is the resin, that is up to 70 to 80%. Other constituents present are sugars, proteins and soluble salts 2 to 4%, wax 4 to 6%, sand, woody matter, insect bodies and other extraneous matter 8 to 12%. A volatile oil is present in traces. The resin can be fractionated into soft and hard components by exhaustive extraction with either the former constituents 30% of the original resin and is brown in color. Both soft and hard resins can be further fractionated by successive extraction with organic solvents. One fraction of soft resin contains free acids and neutral materials including the yellow dye, erythrolacin. The second fraction possibly comprises interests of equivalent amounts of hyaluronic acid and isomers of hyaluronic acid and alcoholic lactone. Coming to the wax present is stick lac is usually obtained as a byproduct in the manufacture of dewaxed shellac. It is known in the trade as shellac wax. Seed lac. Stick lac is crushed by hand or power operated roll mills and washed with water in cup shaped stone vats or steel barrels. It is then dried on cemented floors away from the direct rays of the sun and finally winnowed. The water soluble coloring matter is removed during washing. Washed lac or shed lac thus obtained is in the form of grains, 10 mesh per in or less, yellow or reddish brown in color, adhering impurities amount to 3 to 10%. The lighter impurities float on the surface and form a scum which can be easily removed. The colored water containing lac dye is drained out. The washing is repeated until the dye and most of the impurities are removed. The lac thus cleaned is spread on large clean open air floor to dry. After drying, it is winnowed and sieved to get the commercial variety of seed lac. The dusty lac which is eliminated by sieving is known as molama lac and falls under the category of refuse lac. Potential of India in lac production. Nowadays, there is increased stress on use of eco-friendly and safe material, particularly associated with human contact and consumption. Lac is natural, renewable, biodegradable, versatile and non-toxic resin. Thus, a very good increase in demand for lac worldwide is envisaged. The envisaged objective of enhancing lac production has relevance and importance. It is a source of livelihood of tribal and poor inhabiting forest and sub-forest areas. India is the principal lac producing country of the world, producing approximately 18,000 metric tons of unrefined raw lac annually. About 85% of the country's production is exported to various countries. The USA, Germany, and Egypt are some of the major lac importing countries of the world. Export of lac from India is in the form of shellac or button lac, seed lac, dewaxed lac, bleached lac and aluretric acid. India has great potential for lac culture. The areas for lac cultivation can be broadly classified into three categories. Regular lac cultivation areas, at present only 20 to 25% of the total available trees are being utilized. B. Moderate lac cultivation areas. Around 10 to 15% available trees are being utilized, and C, lac host trees are available, but due to lack of knowledge and awareness, none of the trees are utilized for lac cultivation. Thus, on an average, only 15% of the available lac host trees owned by farmers are being utilized for lac cultivation presently. Indian Lac Research Institute ICAR Nukhum Ranchi, established in 1924, is actively engaged in addressing the objective of enhancing lac productivity and production through transfer and adoption of proven technologies by interfering research, development and extension. The institute has developed various technologies and cultivation packages. By implementing and adopting the scientific method of cultivation, proper host plant management, integrated pest management, enhancing exploitation of unexploited host plants and cultivation through joint forest management program, the lac production can be enhanced in future for the economic growth of the country. Thank you.